Okay, so these chicken thighs. Now, chicken thighs are fantastic for barbecues like this. It's got a lovely fat content, which gives flavour, also helps to keep it nice and juicy. So the first thing I've got to do for the chicken is give it a really good marinade, because it'll take on flavours and spice.
The marinade starts with 3 tablespoons of plain yoghurt.
And into that, some ground cumin, some ground coriander, some cinnamon, and some hot smoked paprika. And then into those spices, I'm going to put a teaspoon of sumac. Now, sumac is kind of like a slightly floral, lemony little red berry. And then 2 teaspoons of baharat. It comes from Turkey. It's got lots of paprika, lots of nutmeg and cinnamon.
I'm quartering the thighs so they fit nicely onto the skewers later on.
And this is where you get your hands in. The touch of seasoning, cracked black pepper and some salt. And give it a final mix in. Gonna go in a fridge for 1 to 2 hours and then be ready to stick on some skewers and get cooking.
Every kebab needs a chili sauce. Char grilling veg on the barbecue is a surefire way to add more flavor. 2 red peppers and a halved onion can go straight over the hottest coals.
They've got so many natural sugars in them. So they'll cook and they'll caramelize, and there's a wonderful sweetness that comes from it. And the more you char it, the more those sugars caramelize.
Burnt garlic can become bitter, so this I'm protecting in some foil.
With a drizzle of olive oil, what I'm trying to achieve here is a steaming process, okay?
Pop this on with the veg.
It does look like they're massively burnt, and that's because, well, they are, but it's the outside skin that's really charred. Don't worry, you're not eating the real burnt black bits. I'm gonna scrape them off in a minute and I'll show you how. Now onto the barbecue, red and green chilies onto the hot bit, and a couple of tomatoes. Just give them a quick turnover. You can use tongs at this point, or like me, if you're brave, just use your fingers and twist them around real quick.
When they're really charred all over, lift them off the barbecue and pop them into a bowl.
Just gonna struggle finding the end of the cling film.
It's worth fumbling with the film, because this is a great tip to get the burnt skins off.
So what's happening when the cling film goes on the top is the heat creates a steam, and that steam will help release those skins when we come to scrape them off.
The garlic can cool down too.
Whoa, look at that. The smell is absolutely stunning.
And after 15 minutes of steaming, the vegetables' flesh should, hopefully, come away from their burnt skins.
Just kind of pinch it. See, let's see how easy that comes off. You can quite happily make a bit of a mess, not worry about it too much. Only really worry about the neighbour's washing, just in case it gets covered in smoky barbecue flavour.
Squeeze the roasted garlic out of the skin, and once everything is chopped through, all of those smoky caramelised flavours will come together.
The more you chop it, the nicer this will become, the more you're mixing all of those flavours together. Stick it back in a bowl.
I'm making this into a salsa with a good pinch of salt, olive oil and sherry vinegar.
Taste. Oh, it's amazing. Sweet, sour kick from the vinegar. Little bits of charred, lovely roasted, almost burnt bits of veg. Absolutely delicious. Stick that to one side.
Those chicken thighs have had a good couple of hours to take on the flavours from the yoghurt and the spice marinade. They're going to make brilliant sheesh kebabs.
Bit of information for you. Sheesh in Turkish means sword. So the sheesh kebab comes across from Turkish soldiers in the Ottoman Empire, putting bits of meat on the end of their sword and then cooking it in open fires. Sounds like the perfect end to a hard day battling to me. Just thread, around about 6 or 7 pieces onto your skewer. On the barbecue here, I've put a few extra coals on that are already super hot. I'm just gonna stick the kebabs on, and straight away you get that sizzle and burn where the grill is nice and hot, and almost the yogurt and the spices burning. That's what you want, but you don't want to actually burn them too deeply. I do want black bits on it, and I do want that lovely charred flavour, but I don't want it as black as those coals, OK? Otherwise, we may as well just eat the charcoal. So after about 15 to 20 minutes, these lovely chicken kebabs are cooked. So it's just a case building a kebab now. Bit of bread.
I'll show you how to make these flatbreads later. I've also made a garlic sauce with the roasted garlic, tahini, and again, a hint of sherry vinegar.
All over the bread, the chicken, and then a little bit of our roasted, warm chili sauce. I say a little bit, but I mean quite a lot.
And some lovely red pickled cabbage.
And then just in case it's not spicy enough, I'm gonna put a couple of my pickled green chilies. Give it a little roll and a wrap. It's gonna get messy. Told ya.
This flatbread dough is simply 280 grams of self-raising flour, 250 grams of plain yogurt, a couple of tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil, and a teaspoon of cumin seeds.
Now, these are really good for texture, crunch, but also flavour. Little pinch of salt. The beautiful thing about using yogurt for this is it's got a really lovely dairy acidity to it. You know, like the flavour you get from a sourdough. If you have toasted sourdough, absolutely delicious. Now, I'm gonna leave it to rest for about half an hour.
The rested flatbread dough won't have risen, but should be smooth and easy to shape.
In this recipe, this will make about 6 flatbreads, OK? So as I'm rolling it, you can feel those little cumin seeds, and they're great for flavour. So you've got a nice, thin dough like this. I'm just going to stick it straight on that barbecue, and it won't take long to cook at all.
They just need a minute on each side.
If you look at that bread now, it's all puffing up, and the air pockets are coming through. Look at that. It smells great. Absolutely fantastic. And that self-raising flour and the yogurt, that's the thing that gives it the rise, the puff.
These are so quick, you can do them fresh to order as your barbecue guests need them.
Or your friends will think you really do know what you're doing.
While still hot, brush with oil or butter.